Hey guys, it's John, and today we are going to be finishing Five Nights at Freddy's sister location. In the last video, I got the bad ending for the game, and this one I'm going to be trying to unlock the secret ending. And some things popped up in extras after we got the bad ending. There's like the usual stuff. You can look at the animatronics, including this one, which I guess we'll find out who that is soon enough. You can also look at these cool little things showing how Scott made each animatronic. Pretty neat. There's also this blueprint, and this kind of shows the layout for the entire game. There's a private room here, which I assume we have to freaking get into in order to access the secret ending. And then there's also, in this corner, the mini game. Now, I know for a fact you have to finish, like, complete this mini game in order to unlock the secret ending. You can't see it. There's a timer. Anyway, I'm gonna just try to beat it. I won't be able to do it this time because I was talking to you guys the whole time, but it'll probably take more than one attempt anyway, so here we go. Come on. Gotta shoot a little bit faster. This is probably one of the nerdier things I've ever done, is attempt this over and over again. I don't know if that saved any time, probably didn't. First time I tried jumping into that screen like that. And in case you're wondering, this is the only route you can take. There we go. 33, that's about right. Okay, this next part sucks. I gotta remember to do this right. Hard part's over. I think we have enough time. Really hope so. Yes! So it's exactly what she described in that little cupboard. And we've done it. 2 stars. Oh. So I got to that point once before, and I didn't know that you had to press forward slash to put down the ice cream cone. And I felt like an idiot. So that was fun. All right, so now what we gotta do, and in my many attempts to beat that mini game, I actually ended up looking this up because I wanna be done with this. In order to get to the private room now, we have to just go the opposite way that Circus Baby tells us to go when we're going on our way to the scooping room. And apparently there's a private room or something. Like, it's the way of the secret ending, so we're just gonna do that.
Go forward.
All right, so apparently we gotta go forward and right.
Access granted.
Okay.
It seems that you have accidentally wandered into a restricted area. Due to the sensitive nature of the materials that you may be exposed to here, you will not be allowed to leave until the cleanup crew arrives at 6 a.m.
Oh, so sweet.
Rest assured that you will be promptly rescued, fired, then sent home. Thank you for being an employee. We hope that your experience has not been as regrettable as ours.
Okay, so what are we looking out for here? I like this. This is like a traditional FNAF night. Okay. I got 90% power already.
Why didn't you trust me?
What? I don't even know what I'm looking for. What am I looking for? Oh!
Why didn't you trust me?
I don't know. Oh! So there's a vent and there's a door on either side. Okay. Okay, I think I just have to check the vent and the two doors. Okay. Ugh. Back in the vent, huh? Shoot. So what is this thing? I didn't even get a good look at it because I've been so, like, paranoid. Okay, it makes that squeaking sound when it crawls away. Heard it to the left. Okay, so I guess it works like the vent where you have to wait for it to lean in.
Sometimes I don't understand why people do the things that they do.
Is that the freaking clown mask? That's the... Oh, that just blew my mind. That's sweet.
I thought you liked me. I thought I did everything right.
That is cool, because I did notice that that was gone earlier. Faked me out. We're running out of power fast, though. I'm gonna need you to leave, man. So is this the spirit of that little girl, or? Man, I gotta get my Five Nights at Freddy's 2 Night 6 thinking cap on here. I've already wasted a lot of power, I think. Maybe we gotta listen.
We need you so that we can live. We need you so that we can hide.
I'm gonna need you to shut up. We need you so that we can look like you. I already know about your little scooper room plan. This is why I headed over here. Heh.
If they find us like this, we won't be able to try again.
43% at 2 a.m.? No, I haven't played FNAF in a while, but I don't think that that's very good. Then again, I don't see that.
If they find us like this, we won't be able to try again.
Okay.
You must help us. You must let us inside the room.
You must let us inside the room. Where's that thing? Like it... I don't even know what it is at this point. I haven't seen it for a while either. I'm only checking those three cameras. Because it seems like...
Isn't this why you came here? To be with her again?
I heard a weird noise just now. I don't know what it meant. I gotta get quicker with the camera. I'm a little slow.
I don't understand.
Dude, it's to the left, isn't it? Sure is. Not great. He left. Again? I'm screwed.
You have to let me inside the room.
It's 5 a.m., but I don't have enough power. I haven't seen it on the right side at all. Fuck. I'm so screwed. Okay, I screwed around too much in that one, but that was my first attempt. Okay, I think I figured it out pretty quickly though. So it got the clown mask, I guess, because, well, it didn't get my exoskeleton, so it can be in disguise. So I guess I had to use something, right? All right, let's do this again. Why isn't it moving?
Isn't this why you came here? To me?
There's no one there. He left. Oh! Did you see that shit?
You won't die. And it will only hurt for a moment.
Shh. Okay. Yep, gotta. Four AM, 35%, that's way better than before. He's there for a long time. That's a lot of power being wasted. Good. I like this. Thought he'd just take a peek inside my office, and I said, no, sir. Fuck. Okay. 26%. Where? Just listening. Not there. Starting to move a lot quicker. Gotta. Did it! All right, I'm excited to see what happens now. What happens in the vampire show?
As the trees sway in the wind, so also do emotions sway between star-crossed lovers.
You burned down my house?
You call that a house? It was like a morgue in there.
I may be undead, but you're heartless.
You need to see your son.
The baby isn't mine.
He ate the cat.
Sounds like something he got from your side of the family.
Well, how's this? I'm keeping the diamond ring.
The joke's on you. I found it in a kid's meal.
You bought a kid's meal? Oh, Vlad!
Clara!
As the hair on the back of a cat stands up straight, so also does the love between Vlad and Clara stand up against all obstacles. But what about the baby? What about the bat child support? Stay tuned next season for those answers and more.
Nice. All right, so what spooky thing is going to happen in the room? Oh. It followed me home. Hey, what's up? You want some popcorn? I got plenty, as you can see. It never seems to become empty, actually, so... I don't know if you animatronics eat, but... Does it say something? All I can see is an F. I guess Five Nights at Freddy's, I don't know. Anyway, so that was the secret ending. Oh, I can see it on my thing. It says fake ending, I think. What the hell? I can only see it because I've got the gamma a little bit brighter on my recording. Anyway, okay, whatever. Fake ending or not, that was way more badass than the other one. Alright, so, as far as I know, there's nothing else to Sister Location just yet. We may be looking at some DLC in the future, just like with FNAF 4. As for my thoughts on Sister Location, so now that I've played all the content in the game, I kind of feel a little bit better about providing an assessment for the game, I guess. First, let's see that glorious 3-star. That's what I like to see. So Sister Location, it's without a doubt very, very different from the other Five Nights at Freddy's games, which I think in one way it's good, right? Because I think after the fourth one, the formula started wearing thin. I really like the fourth one, for the record, but I do think that at that point, a lot of people were beginning to think that the series was a little too repetitive, so this definitely shook things up. With that said, this probably is my least favorite in the series. It's not really for me, I don't think. I really liked that last night where we were given traditional gameplay, but like, for the rest of the game, I felt like it was just FNAF minigames, and a lot of them were, I think, remarkably boring. Like, I'm not trying to tear the game to shreds or anything. I still think it was, you know, it was an alright experience, and I think Scott's a great developer. I think he's capable of creating really unique things, as evidenced by Five Nights at Freddy's effect on gaming since it's released. I think it kind of flipped the horror genre on its head. And I think it's one of the most important games to come out, period, in the last few years. But with that said, I do think that this one just, it kind of fell short for me. Back to what I was saying about some of the levels, like going through the Ballora hallway, going through the Funtime Foxy hallway several times, you're just kind of running through darkness. And like, there's a pattern to it, but I just didn't really get a whole lot of satisfying gameplay out of it, to be honest. I think that's my biggest issue with the game, is that it's not satisfying. It didn't satisfy me the way that previous FNAF games did. Now, I'm coming at this from a little bit different perspective than most people who like the series. I'm not here for the story, I'm here for the gameplay. So, since the gameplay was shaken up quite a bit, you know, I am probably going to view this a little bit differently than those that are here for the story, because story-wise, I think this is pretty strong, as usual. The gameplay was lacking for me. I felt confused at every turn, but still able to, like, pull it off, like, in the, breaker room or whatever that was on night two. I still don't really understand exactly what I was doing, but I got past it, you know. And then like catching the Bonnie button, you know, that was kind of fun. I think it was a cool scare when you look over and see the hands missing. That was definitely neat. There were some cool moments in this, but just there was a lot of monologuing, and there just wasn't enough gameplay for me, I guess, is my core criticism. But, you know, I'm not, like I said, I'm not trying to, like, bash the game or anything. It wasn't what I expected, I guess, which probably affected how I view the game. You know, I'm viewing it through the lens of someone who was like, oh, it's gonna be Five Nights at Freddy's 5. I can't wait to play Five Nights at Freddy's 5. These are the lenses. Aforementioned lenses. And then when I got here, you know, it was like, I mean, when Scott, you know, emailed me about the game as it came out, he said it was a lot different, and that's the first I heard of it, because I watched the trailer, but I wasn't keeping up with the development or the teasers or the, you know, news that was coming out. I watched the trailer, I was like, looks cool, I'll wait and I'll play it when it comes out, you know. And so I had no idea that it was going to be this different than the previous games. I guess, I don't know, maybe some other people were more prepared for this than I was. I don't know how much was leaked beforehand. But I have a lot of thoughts about this game, so if you're looking at the end time of the video, it's probably a ways from now, because I just have a lot of things I feel like I need to get off my chest about this. I know that there are a lot of people in the comments. I've seen a lot of them just on this series and in previous videos really praising the game, which is great to see, honestly, because I'm used to seeing just Five Nights at Freddy's games get torn to shreds in my comment section, which is kind of disheartening because, like I said, I am a fan of the original four games. I've seen a lot of compliments directed towards this one in particular, and I guess it's due to the production value because it's definitely higher. I mean, there's voice acting, there's cutscenes, if you can call them that. There's like little Portal style humor injected. You know, I've seen a lot of people praise the production value, basically. And, you know, you could walk around, you're not restricted to one room. For me, though, I think all of these things kind of detracted from what I liked, what I personally liked about Five Nights at Freddy's, which was the gameplay, the feeling of claustrophobia, you know, you're trapped in this room. And, you know, there's always that lingering question of, like, why don't you just go home after you survived the night? Why would you ever go back? And this one, they did answer that with the story, but for me, you know, it didn't really ever cross my mind. I was able to kind of suspend disbelief. It never seriously crossed my mind. Like, of course, I jokingly commentated about in the videos, like, why would you ever go back here? Yeah, everybody fucking said that in their Let's Play videos, so I'm not very original. But, you know, it didn't feel as trapping this time. The environment felt less oppressive because you went everywhere kind of by choice. It's like, yeah, you had this kind of domineering voiceover saying, like, go repair Funtime Freddy. Go repair Funtime Foxy. Or, you never repaired Foxy. You know, you guys know what I meant. And then you went and did it, right? And you walked through the fucking dark hallway and you went and did it. It's a little bit different than, like, I think there's something to be said for the original four games where, like, you survive a night and then unless you press escape and quit, it just plops you right back in that chair or on that bed and you have to do it all over again. You know, and in this one, you could actually, like, sit on the screens for quite some time doing nothing and nothing would happen. I think that sense of urgency was kind of lost with this one. Whereas in Five Nights at Freddy's, like, you had to just keep going. You had to keep going or else you were going to get eaten by one of the animatronics. And it's a little thing, but I think it did add something, at least for me. And, you know, going back to the gameplay thing, that was always what I thought was Five Nights at Freddy's biggest strength. I know a lot of people viewed it as repetitive because in every iteration it seemed like it was just the same thing. But for me, it was different every time, and I really liked that learning curve that you experienced through the game. I think that especially for all of Five Nights at Freddy's 2's flaws, I believe it did a great job of gradually making things harder, adding new elements until everything just went batshit crazy. That's probably the thing that I liked the most about 2. The music box, winding the music box kind of put a little over the top, but, you know, adding the toy animatronics at first and then adding the withered animatronics and then you got Balloon Boy and then you got Golden Freddy in the later nights. I think it was awesome. You know, the mask and everything, just mechanically, it was really interesting. But in this one, you know, like I said earlier, it's like a collection of FNAF minigames. There's no continuity. There's no, like, you know, gradual difficulty ramp or anything. It's just, okay, you go to the break room. Oh, you fixed that? Okay, time to walk through Funtime Foxy's hallway. You know, try to catch Bonnie and then, like, press these knobs. I think Night 4 is some of the most, with the exception of the entirety of Five Nights at Freddy's 3, it's probably the most bored I've been playing these games. It's just monotonous. And, like, I mean, believe it or not, I'm really not trying to tear this game to shreds or anything. I enjoy the series. I just didn't enjoy this particular iteration or its execution of the gameplay. But, like, Night 4 just, I mean, it just felt like, it felt menial. It was like, there were four different buttons, and you had to just, you had to click on them to rotate them, and you had to keep them rotated. Just what? I don't know. Like, it's the type of thing where, like, if I was playing that in any other game, I would be like, fuck this. The only reason that I went through that was because it's a Five Nights at Freddy's game. I'm like, oh, well, I want to see what's in Night 5. I want to see, you know, there's probably secrets and other endings, and I want to get to that stuff. I want to get to the good stuff. But, like, if I was playing a game and I was playing that level and anything else, I don't know if I would go through with it. That was kind of terrible, in my opinion. Now, to the game's credit, though, it did shake things up, and that it's a big risk, honestly, when you've got a tried-and-true formula with the first four games of the series, and then you deviate from that, that's a risk, you know? For me, it didn't pan out, but for a lot of other people, apparently it did. Judging from what I've seen, just feedback from other people, people who I've seen say terrible things about the first four games, I've seen say good things about this one. So, you know, Scott did something right by those people. So it's just one man's opinion, but that's my personal take on the game. Didn't enjoy it because, you know, once again, I'm here for the gameplay, not the story. Story was fine, but, you know, the gameplay for me was lacking. I guess that's the main thing I want to get across. And my thoughts are kind of jumbled right now because I just beat it, and I'm just kind of talking right after the credits off the cuff. But hopefully my feedback was comprehensive enough to understand my point of view. That's really it. You don't have to agree with me, but obviously, but I just want to make sure that my viewpoint is properly conveyed. And, you know, for the record, I really like Scott as a developer. I mean, when he released Five Nights at Freddy's 1, it cannot be understated how big of a revolution that was in horror games. And I know a lot of people try to sweep it under the rug and try to act like it wasn't that big of a deal. Like, oh, well, Night Trap came 20... Like, fucking, who was Let's Playing Night Trap on YouTube? You know what I mean? Not that Let's Play dictates everything, but come on. Like, people weren't talking about Night Trap, you know, 20 years later. Like, they're probably going to talk about this game 20 years from now, in my opinion. That's just me. But it really brought something new to the table, and I do like the fact that Scott's trying to bring something new to the table again with this one. So I think that it should be praised. However, I have seen a lot of comments, things like, wow, a FNAF game with actual effort put into it. I could not disagree with those comments more. I think that this you know, it's been a year and 3 months since the last FNAF game. But I don't think that this necessarily had more effort put into it than the previous games. I think that the previous games had a good amount of effort put into them. There's planning, there's design, you know, Scott designs all these creatures and himself, he puts them together. Come on, like, there is actual effort put into those games. I know it's just hyperbole, but it still bugs me. And, like, just because the production value of this game is higher, I feel like a lot of people are just kind of smitten with the voice acting and the cutscenes and the, oh, you can move around now, you know, that kind of stuff. And while that's great, you know, very happy to see it, doesn't mean that there was more effort put into this one. Just wanted to say that, and that's pretty much all I have to say about Sister Location. Think it's cool. At this point, I'm gonna play the rest of Scott Cawthon's games that he comes out with, you know. So this, it's not like just because I didn't care for this one, like, I'm done. You know, I'm gonna play the next one because I'm curious to see what he comes up with, what happens. But yeah, just kind of missed the mark for me this time. But I really did like 1 and 4 in particular. So, you know, I'm gonna stick around and hope that another one hits me like those did, basically. All right, but let me know what you guys thought in the comments. This is probably the longest I've talked about a game after I'm done playing it, so sorry for rambling so much, but I just felt like there was a lot to cover. And yeah, we're gonna move on to other games now. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Think critically.